or Clubhouse, and Coastline is one of the, if not their best map.
Better part of a year now. So teams will
sneak it right in. Canterbury, Kenny will take him out. We have a C4 moving in. Oh, it's not going to be able to stop the plant from going down, but it does confirm the second kill for G2. Goga, he's already on the counter defuse, trying to spam through on a hard ping. Fabian, though, is going to be able to take out Bio. Pingo finishes off Merc, and there we go. G2 shut it down on the retake.
Well, Pengu's still holding down Piano as well. Kant with a very nice shot from upstairs.
Gonna take some damage, but he ends up coming out on top of a duel versus Goga. We see another kill picked up as well here. Quite an exchange as we'll take a quick look there at Uno's kill from a few seconds ago, but ultimately Kanto and Uno, that roaming presently, they can't really know that much about it. A nade going in, it is gonna finish off Pengu and take him down.
One takes down achieved as they get closer to equalizing. It appears that he will also be able to maintain his life as he rotates back in. Diffuser now going down for Pojo as Kanto will pick up one as Fabian rotates in, but Merc will be able to clean him up. Diffuser will get confirmed, and Kanto doesn't really seem to have a will or a way to get through with this right now. Rotation in from Poge with some quick shots as Kanto can't win it out, and TSM with their very first round as they're trying to battle back. Lobby area, and you're able to shut down anyone that's attempting to plant inside of the corner, but it's not going to help out too far. Bolo's going to pre-fire, but Fabian will put him inside of the grinder as well. Uno continues
too much. The angle has now been established by Fabian, and a quick adjustment to his head will knock out Pojo Man.
Dip back in quickly.
We have seen G2 retreat all five and they rotated. Pengu as well establishes an angle through the floorboards there to try and knock out one of the players, but is not going to find it. Uno picks up a kill, achieved from the attacking side, will be able to trade, but now he's limited, also with less than 30 seconds left here to push into it. Not much hope. Uno with one more peek, finishes.
Have in lobby, they have Uno downstairs, as well as they have Kanto that's playing inside a piano. Some one taps will follow suit, and actually Kanto and Goga both go fishing and find two. Uno removing a drum from play, actually might come up with a kill here, a quick flick, but he's going to be met with actually dual pressure. As achieved pressures the front on site, we've seen these two throughout this entire tournament perform so fantastic. Fabian gets shut down from the flag hallway as Bolo finds his first kill. Kanto can stop Diffuser though, as you see the black eye cam in the corner trying to grab his shoulder, but he can't. Does a little bit of damage, pre-fires, finds Bolo, has a pistol, isn't able to win out against achieved and TSM with their second round.
So at the end of the first half, we'll sit at 2-4.
Only scot free, but not from lack of bullets, as we will have yet another kill come through. It'll be Bolo taking down Fabian. That's actually a massive pick, the Jackal now.
And it's left only Uno along with Kanto alive. Kanto as well with a sliver of HP remaining. Achieved with another nice pickup. Kanto trades him out, but it doesn't matter. We'll see Bolo or Biologic pick up the final kill, and TSM will pick up their first defensive round. Genius for our defenders.
Siege is just all about minor inconvenience.
Hello, achieved.
Yeah. Bio's actually been downed, and Bolo will soon be shut down as well. It's all left up to Merc to try and battle back. Can't find anything. Definitely not going to be going outside for Biologic either, as Goga's trying to find his shoulder. He does. He'll rip the head off of Bio. This is more than likely going to be a G2 round, as Fabian will put a cap on that in G2. Possible stun grenades now roll into CEO as it's the upside down repel and a quick execution of Bolo.
Defender has left the designated staging area.
Pojoman trying to get aggressive outside, but it only ends up giving him away. Fabian catches the outside notification and quickly adjusts on the spiral stairs, be able to take him out. Goga will now have access to the site. He'll start putting the diffuser on the ground, but it won't even be necessary. Of the actual main phase of the round, just to reassure that there's no roaming presence that is later pushed in.
Oh!
And what is that from achieved? Running out with a double kill.
Actually, okay, Uno actually picks him off from Spiral, so it wasn't Spiral. I don't know exactly where he was able to claim those two kills at, but
that leaves only Uno in the fight. And even worse, the diffuser.
Oh,
what? What an adjustment from Uno right there. I was about to say diffuser onto the ground. Uno's been able to retrieve it. However, the problem for Uno is, of course, the very, very low HP that he now had to work with until Merc took him down. And TSM secured another round. Absolutely necessary to need a hard breacher to successfully attack, but it certainly helps. Fabian will instead get the first kill on the window swing, and they'll also pop off their first EE1D charge. As the defensive setup from TSM, it's been forced back. Kanto's been able to pick achieved in the lobby. Bio, yes, will trade onto Uno, but again,
to have enough time outside to stay alive. Fabian takes down one. Fabian is immediately traded out, though, as Bolo will remove him from play. Goga popping off right now as Bolo will fall. It's only left up to Bio, SMG 11 by his side. Way too difficult to really formulate anything. All it's going to take is a quick rappel and more than likely a victory. Kanto from all the way outside his IQ will bring G2 one step closer. From that mirror, you're able to peek off of and try and claim a free kill. So she, why do you have to go past your old ways?
Once again, we were talking in the earlier portions of the match as well about how runouts were crucial. However, remaining here, Fabian hunting for a mistake on TSM.
Ooh.
And hoping that they peek the hole, but no. A grenade gets chucked through and achieved. Finishes it off with a final shot. Tries to turn it around, but Merc accidentally.
Going for a stroll over towards the aviator door. Pengu will actually take down Biologic, so all of a sudden this becomes easier. This is a 2v2. Pengu with the support as Goga takes down one. It's all up to Pojo, and Pengu, once again, the team play from G2! Fabian, though, now trying to hold down Bathroom. TSM does have control of Astronomy, which is a big backbone to the site. You can actually gain access to both.
Cover it onto Bolo. This is once again brought to a very nearly even situation. Achieve once again, though. Able to find a pick, knocking out Kanto, and leaving only Fabian in the fight. Achieve will manage him as well, so there's the response.
Work out, it will mark up Goga, but it doesn't even matter. They won't even contest him. Finally, Pojo works his way in with a Barry 9, takes down Goga. Kanto in trouble. Pengu battles back, and it's actually going to be a trade out as Pojo takes down Kanto and rotated to the hallway. I don't know if they're going to account for it. Pengu takes down one with the SMG 11. Now it's turned into a kill box, but Pojo finds one. That's going to be a triple kill for him on the round. He's just waiting for that plant sound. Pojo has to try and find him, but from behind, it's Pengu. Pojo not accounting for when the man could possibly be.
We can see the kill from Kanto happening there just a few moments ago too. Uno can be next to strike, however. Kanto ready for another fight as he also picks up his own personal second and a third for his team. All long as no one else creeps up behind him, he's safe. Uno finds the next pick as he's able to eliminate Biologic, and then finally Pengu pushes with the clash to finish off the round, eliminating Pojo Man.
Excited for this map as we are in living room, but Uno's going to start things off as we have quite a bit of pressure upstairs by G2, and it's going to continue to roll. Merc finally finds an opening kill for TSM as he actually battles back. This is a Merc we've been waiting for.
It will expire in just a moment. G2, as Fabian picks up that final kill, wants to truly find impact here.
This is where your flank drones are definitely going to come in and be important. Uno will fall in the process of Goga on this rotation. He does works his way up. Achieve's actually on drone. That's going to be a free kill. Merc's going to try and challenge from the staircase. Doesn't win it out. Flicks around. Actually finds Zofia. Bolo's looking the wrong way. Challenges with the pistol, but is actually not going to get
alive?
Down. I don't even understand how that happened.
Deal with later on in the round. Pojo Man finding Goga, though, and finally dealing with that issue, along with Merc being able to pick up Pengu, might have just sealed the deal now for TSM. It's all on Kanto. A nice find from Pojo to take him out. And it also drops the diffuser onto the ground with just 20 seconds remaining, but he's going to get pincered here. Needs to be very careful with how he uses these next 15 seconds, as that's all he needs to do. Run the timer down. He's won the round. Tries to spam it a little bit, but no. Biologic catches him from the kitchen, and TSM will be able to claim another round at the end of the half.
That is Goga will fall, making this an even trade. Fabian now jumps down red, immediately claims Bio's life, and makes this a little bit easier, bringing man control back to G2. Any members of TSM, no damage done to either of them. Fabian and Kanto at half health as things begin to pop off. Pojo falls. Fabian with a second, and G2 once again finds away. The Jackal utility helped them out quite a bit on that last round, but it's going to be an extremely aggressive front as Goga tries to battle back, but he will take down, it'll actually be Uno, apologies. Achieve, though, will battle back as well as he takes down Pengu.
By the way, so quite a bit of action for this early on in the round. Biologic adds another kill to his team's counter, though, as they're able to find Goga out. Not much damage connecting at all there. All three of the TSM players still say completely safe. For Uno, oh, there we go, a bit of hunting. Finally comes out with something. He's still got a little over a minute left, but finally, Biologic takes him down, and it's TSM's round. Against players like Achieve, who actually doesn't seem like he noticed the drone sitting behind him there on the inside of Astronomy, which could be trouble, but Goga strikes first here, being able to knock out Merc, and they look for the second against the player behind the desk. He doesn't really have much of a desk going anymore. Uno gonna be going in for the trade. Goga and Fabian immediately pick up two more.
Than it already was. Even in the 1v4 situation, the diffuser down makes things all the more complicated. That smoke's going to dissipate, giving the line of sight back to Pojo. The Alda, such a fantastic weapon, but he still has to find three people with 14 bullets. That thing takes quite a while to reload as well.
Tracker on him now, yep. Too.
Tracker on him as well. Still four pings to go, and Jackal does an extremely difficult thing. Pojo Man just nodding. He appears ready for this, and he might surprise. Quite a bit of damage, but to no avail.
It's not going to happen, folks. In sight, they do not want to deal with that in an open duel if they can avoid it.
Especially the mental process of that, it's more or less, you peek, you think you hear some shuffling of a shield, all of a sudden it's death to everyone on the other end of G2. TSM falling apart at the seams as Pengu. More than likely there is a rotation, yes, Fabian rotating in from behind. Is there going to peek from both ends? Bolo's actually going to trade it out towards Uno, but Fabian takes down Merc as Pengu is still alive.
And they can use this to push into the site relatively unhindered. You can see he takes blips of damage, but it's not going to matter. So much control over the outcome of the round here. Goga finishes off Bolo, and it leaves only Pojo Man alive. He does have a flank capability though to try and move around these players, but it's already been spotted, and Fabian has it iced out. That's the end of the match, ladies and gentlemen. G2 are moving through once again to the semifinals, and TSM, the last hope for North America, is now out of the event, eliminating the entire region along with it.